anything to anybody, was not helping. So what we need is have a conversation about the pedagogical piece. Once you have that conversation, then you're able to manage it in a better way what technology might or might not work for. And then the mentors are the ones that have those conversations with them, the pedagogical conversations with them about this is what worked for me. And one of the interesting things that happens is that the mentors enroll the developers to their courses because of their teaching right now. So they have an exposure to see how the course is functioning in a course that is being taught at that time. And from what else from that? And we are always there for them. So anything that they need to do in terms of the technology, we try to make sure that they don't find that as a barrier. Usually trying to access new technologies, trying to access new things is scary at first, not knowing how it's going to be impacting it the way you used to teach for a number of semesters or so. So then you are careful in trying new things and not knowing what the end result is going to be. So being there to help them just alleviates kind of that tension.
And what's the ratio for instructional design?
We have
one of these that I wanted to connect with what the keynote said at the beginning, right? So it's about how the teacher teaches. So it could be in any modality. So we've seen kind of the same thing. So faculty is getting good results teaching face-to-face hybrid will have similar or compatible results when they're teaching online. So we're trying to put the emphasis on that piece in making sure that we provide that professional development to faculty to be able to help in enhancing those good methodologies that they're using so that students can benefit at the end for that. Yeah. That goes depending on the needs of the faculty member. So we provide the support, we provide all the help that they might need, but the decision on using the technology, and that is why this conversation, this initial conversation with the faculty member is crucial. Because they might find that, you know, the problem is that my students are always checking Facebook and not paying attention to my class. So then a possible solution in that conversation could be, okay, so let's go where they are. Let's try to connect Facebook because that is the problem that you're facing. That might not be a problem for another faculty member, which is fine using email. And the students feel comfortable doing that. So that goes case by case. And we have what is called intellectual freedom at CUNY, and it's very strong. So we don't tell faculty how to teach. We just provide recommendations on a given problem that they're facing at that moment. So, and even then, that conversation might be more approachable in considering a new methodology like social media. Yes, yes, and we do provide, see, these are targeted trainings for online development. We do provide a whole gamut of professional development for faculty, that is general sessions, general topics. Faculty who are interested in those different topics, they go there and they, oh, I'm interested in how to use Facebook, and we provide workshops about social media. And then those faculty who are interested, then we engage in that conversation. There is a whole variety on it's various, but there, the one common denominator is there's not one reason that they chose because they liked the course to be an online course. Yeah. That was not present. It was many other different reasons. Oh, because I like the instructor that is teaching this course, and even though he's not teaching face to face, but I like the instructor, so I'm taking this course, even though it's an online course. So that was kind of pretty broad in the questions, in the answers they provided. Yes?
I was wondering about a question in the survey that indicated that students felt that the communication was, I think the categories were working on were majority, like average, and a small percentage thought that it was above average and excellent. And then the faculty perceptions were a little better, or about the student perceptions about faculty.
That's an important question. One of the things that we're planning to do is push it to create a community of practice. So we've been doing that in general for technology innovation, and it's been very helpful. So faculty are not as scared to try new things because they have a network of colleagues that could support and could help and guide them. So we are trying to identify all those faculty, everybody that has been teaching online courses, to bring them to have different encounters or sessions, and so that we can have that type of conversation and then do it in a sense of a dialogue more than here is a problem, we have to fix it, and then trying to, from those conversations, trying to bring some solutions, some recommendations that come from colleagues. Usually, the way the message is perceived, it is more direct if it comes from a colleague than coming from even from administration. When administration tells you what to do, then you are kind of. But then, if you have a conversation with colleagues, you might be able to be more receptive to that. So, that is one of these that we're planning to do, and see how bringing this network of all the faculty that have been teaching online courses and start to have these type of conversations. We'll let you know how that goes. Any other question? I think we are good on time. Yeah, we're good. No more questions? So we're happy to share the information. The PowerPoint is there. We'll share the survey questions. That's fine. And as I said, this is general knowledge. It's nothing copyrighted, top secret, or anything. So thank you very much for coming, and look forward to continue the conversation with everybody.
For those of you that don't have the evaluation form, please let me know. Those of you that already fill it, please give me to on the way out.